So I think we should get back together. Dumping you was a big mistake. A big, big... Oh, you're so freaking sexy. You have the roundest, sweetest, most incredible...
Rocco, why are you calling my daughter at this hour? Do you have any idea what time it is?
No. Do you?
Whatever you have to tell her can certainly wait until this weekend when she's down there visiting State U.
Mom, hang up the phone! Hang up! Rocco, are you high?
Depends on what you're wearing.
Stop calling me and leaving drunk messages on my machine, jackass! What?
Could you put your mom back on the phone? She sounded kind of sexy.
To me, on my computer screen, the pictures of our lives aren't as easy as they seem. To get the girl and make the grade, it's all a show, it's all a game, and I would lose it if I played. But anyway, you go out on Friday night.
Thanks for coming to the Safe Sex Floor Meeting. I'm super proud to see all my residents take this issue as seriously as I do.
Your flyer stated there would be chips and soda available. I highlighted the relevant sections.
Look, everyone. I made an ostrich.
Hey, Nitz. You accidentally dropped your safe sex pamphlet and free condoms in the trash.
Oh, did I? Thanks, Jesse.
God, Betsy. Would Jonah like me better if I wore thong underwear and put out? Ew!
Listen up, homies. The Duggler's gonna rap serious with you for a second. Date rape is no laughing matter.
Garfield, how are you ever gonna eat that much lasagna?
Peeps?
Oh, sorry.
Like I was saying, date rape, no laughing matter. To illustrate this point, here's a reenactment skit from Health Services. Peace out.
Oh my God, what's Rocco doing here?
Who are you talking to?
Well, here we are, insert actress's name. Would you like to come up to my room?
I don't know. I don't really know you.
You know I've got a futon and a boner. What more do you need?
Freeze. Now what's going on here? What should... Rocco, I said freeze.
But I haven't even copped a feel yet. What kind of crappy date rape is this?
That was such a joke. My mother talks about sex more maturely. And she uses words like pee-pee and bunny hole.
Annette, what does promiscuous mean?
People who sleep with lots of people, Cal.
Ah, phew, guy. Good thing I never slept with any of my lady friends. We just played a little game I like to call unprotected sex.
And here's the star of our show now.
Oh, that stupid idiot fired me.
Why were you even in that skit in the first place? You don't go to our school.
My ex is coming to check out State U, so I need to find a girl to make her jealous. And I thought the date rape sketch thing would be a good way to meet chicks.
Rocco had a girlfriend? Was she mentally challenged or like a man or something? Okay, fine. For the sake of conversation, let's say your ex wasn't a total whack job. Why'd you break up?
It's sort of complicated. I know it's prom and all, but I'm breaking up with you so I can get laid by tons of chicks when I go to college.
Oh,
yeah, happy birthday.
Hey, guys, what are you talking about?
How Rocco dumped his ex.
Yeah, how dumb was that? He'll never get laid again in his life. Great news. I've created a program that allows me to hack into any PC and install a Jillian Anderson screensaver. Watch.
Sexy Miss Scully. I wonder if she ever had gonorrhea.
Real great, Gimpy.
Yeah, great if you're a freaking nerd.
Hey, peeps. Super screensaver. Listen, I've read all of the sex pamphlets thoroughly, so if you have any questions about what you've heard tonight, my door is always open.
I got a question. Why are you such a wad?
I do not see you, I do not hear you, I will not let you get in the Duggler's head with your bring down.
Yeah, right. Like I would ask the Duggler anything about sex? He's a total VID. Virgin in denial.
How do you know?
Come on. You can tell someone's a virgin just by looking at them.
Wow, Why aren't any of you looking at my Scully screensaver? Look at it! Look at it!
We've seen it, Gimpy.
But only with your eyes and not your heart.
So, you want to have sex?
You tried that one yesterday, Einstein.
Oh, sorry. All chicks look alike to me.
Jessie doesn't know what she's talking about. You can't tell a person is a virgin just by looking at them. I mean, I don't look like a virgin. Do I? Cal?
Spreads quickly, leaving boils on the penis. Boy, I hope I don't...
Kimmy, what are you doing?
Hi, Nitz. Oh, I volunteer as a big sister to inner-city kids twice a week. Today we're finger painting.
My mommy shot my daddy because she loves me.
Mm-hmm.
I also volunteer at the Cancer Ward, Amnesty International, the Free Clinic, Greenpeace, the Free Tibet Organization, UNICEF. She's done.
She's so pure and good. Don't you see? She's like the Virgin Kimmy.
Dudes, stop talking all this virgin crap and help me find a slut.
Ah, sorry, lady. No can do. What if you have something bad that burns?
Hello.
Ah.
Kyle bad, me good. Sex, you want to have?
Ew,
I think he touched my arm.
Let me see if I understand. No one cares about my screensaver, yet you're all content to drone on for hours about this new obsession you have with sex. Girls are the enemy. End of story.
Well, not all girls.
All girls.
Even Rosie O'Donnell?
All girls.
Dude, what about Scully?
Agent Dana Scully is a woman of reason, science, and sharp Armani suits. She's a sterling example of American womanhood, untouchable by human hand.
Well, except for Mulder's.
The hell?
Yeah, dude. You know Mulder and Scully totally do the nasty.
Blasphemers! Mm-hmm. You will rue the day you besmirch the sanctity of Agent Scully.
Oh.
Hmm. Free condoms. What about free self-restraint? No one would have to wait in line to pick up some free morals, would they?
Talking loud is fun! Thanks for coming to the health center with me while I get tested, best buddy.
Yeah, well, anything to stop you from quoting STD pamphlets in your sleep.
As a general rule, we advise all patients not to have sex until your test results come back.
For a whole hour?
No, for a couple of days.
Ah, phew. You scared me for a second.
Sorry I'm late, but I've been running around all day and this is totally boring, right? Anyway, I'll take 1,000 condoms, some lubricated, some unlubricated. Oh, and the red ones are great. Oh, hi, Nitz. How are you?
What an idiot.
Kimmy's a virgin like me. How stupid.
Hey, guy. Oh, you're fast.
Yeah, not as fast as Kimmy. If she wants to behave like a indiscriminate, fine. But not me. I'm going to show all the Kimmys of this world that I'm proud to be a virgin.
Yay, me too. I'm a virgin now too, guy.
Oh, now you want my help. The same man who hours ago defamed Scully the Pure.
Come on, Gimp. My ex is coming this weekend and I can't find a girl. You're smart. I need you to think of something.
Tell you what. I'll help you if you promise to take back what you said about Scully and allow me to broadcast your retraction over the net.
Fine, fine. Anything.
Please sign and initial this release form at the exit. We'll order you a bride online. You can use her to make your ex-girlfriend jealous, then simply return her to her war-torn Eastern European country within 7 days for a complete refund.
Hello. My name is Petrova Nablyovka. My father, mother, brother, and two sisters have all been killed in the fight for liberation. I enjoy cooking for soldiers, sewing up bullet wounds, and walks before curfew.
Dude, she's hot. I want her.
That'll be $16,000, plus shipping and handling.
Do they take Midas muffler points?
No, Visa and MasterCard only.
Damn.
Oh, well, we tried. Now, if you'll stand over there, I'll film your retract.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You've forgotten one thing, my friend. I've got a legally binding signed contract here requiring you to perform the services as prompt.
Huh? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I need to have that bricked up.
Like a virgin. Hey! Touch for the very first time. Like a virgin. With your heartbeat next to mine.
Hi, thanks for coming to our campus support group for virgins. I'm Nitz Walsh, and this is Cal Evans.
Hi, Cal.
You're so fine.
then you're mine. I'll be yours till the end of time, 'cause you made me feel. Yeah, you made me feel.
Come in.
Hi, Nitz. Got a minute?
Not really. I'm kind of busy.
I just wanted to talk about the health center the other day. I saw you run out and...
I was late for church, that's all. I was late for church and you were picking up a kilo of condoms. There's nothing more to talk about.
Nitz, I work part-time at the health center. Part of my job is to coordinate safe sex presentations with the dorm RAs and advise students on their sexual choices. That's what I was picking up the condoms for.
Blah.
When I saw you run out of the center, I got the feeling that you were embarrassed and you totally shouldn't be.
Blah?
No, that's why I'm here, to set the record straight.
Ooh.
Because when two responsible, caring people make love, it can be one of the most totally amazing experiences ever. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Look, I know this is a lot of information to process all at once, and that's okay.
Yeah.
And don't feel badly. Most guys early on in their sexual lives don't even know how to properly put on a condom. Here, let me show you. Always start from the tip and gently massage the condom down.
Hey, buddy guy.
Well, what happened? Where's Kimmy?
She left. Nice ass.
Guys, I've got big news. Kimmy Burton came to my room and told me she wants to have sex with me.
Yay! Wait, I mean boo!
Shia, I think you hit your head a little too hard.
It's true. She sat right here and showed me how to properly put on a condom. Where's the banana?
I ate it.
There was a condom on it. But it does seem a little weird, doesn't it? I mean, a few months ago, Kimmy didn't even know my name. Now she suddenly wants to have sex with me?
Because you were being extra virginal. It made her realize she loves you.
That is so stupid. You think a girl wants to sleep with him because he's acting all sensitive and hugging puppies and wanting to talk about feelings?
Oh my god! I love hugging puppies too! Hey, aren't you that creepy guy from those date rape skits?
Being extra virginal. Being extra virginal.
Shut up, Cal's voice in my head.
Okay, sorry, guy.
Hi, I'm Rocco, and sensitivity training is my life. Did I mention I'm a virgin?
Kimmy, hi, it's... Kimmy, hi, it's Nit. Kimmy, hi. Let's do it. Kimmy? Hey, it's Nitz.
Oh, hey, Nitz, I'm glad you called. I've been thinking about you. How you feeling?
Fine. Sorry for passing out the other day. I was just really tired.
Yeah, I know that feeling.
So I've been thinking about what you were saying, and I think I'm ready.
Great. Want to get together this weekend?
So soon?
I'm working at the health center, so why don't you just come by there?
The health center? Okay. I guess that's good. See you then. Holy crap.
So I told her it was the best apple brown Betty I ever tasted and gave her a daisy I grew in my garden.
Oh my god, Rocco, that is so sweet. I so admire a guy who's close to his mother.
And Kimmy wants to meet at the health center this weekend, so quick, Cal, tell me how to seduce a woman.
Sorry, guy, no can do. I'm a virgin now. I can't have sex until I get married, because I don't want to burn in hell.
Dude, whatever you do, just don't be yourself. It's totally working for me. Gotta pick up my bitch for another date.
I'm sending you an audio file of a Chris Carter interview on NPR where he explicitly denies any carnal relationship between Mulder and Scully.
Sorry, Gimp. Gotta go. I gotta go find out about life, about women, about what makes them tick, their likes and dislikes, and how to make sweet, sweet love to them all night long.
The hell?
Thank you, Garcia. How to get a life, how to take a life. Ah, here it is. How to Seduce a Woman.
How to Seduce a Woman? No way, man. You on the skunkweed? This isn't how you do it, bro.
Well, then how am I supposed to learn?
Chocolate trouble, sweet lady cane, fists of dynamite, lips of love, Sir Pencilot, and my personal favorite, Black Jackson, mother...
Don't you have tapes to rewind, Whitey?
Look at those ancient cave drawings. It's amazing how man, even in its most primitive state, will strive to leave his indelible mark on the world.
And that hairy chick, she's really stacked.
I suppose so. In a very... Earth Mother giving birth to the entire race sort of way. Wow, Rocco, you are so deep. Do you want to buy some vanilla fudge and read poetry to each other?
Only if I can braid your hair afterwards.
Betsy, it's finally happened. I have met the guy I always dreamed I would meet at college. He's so caring and sensitive.
Watch your ass, chocolate.
What's the matter, Tyree? You not man enough to watch it for me? I got your number, Black Jackson.
Ding! Now serving 28, baby. And one size does fit all. I ain't never seen that slut in my life.
Well, maybe this'll refresh your memory, Sir Pimps-a-Lot.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that chocolate sauce is nothing but sweet-ass trouble.
Oh, yeah, yep. You can say that again.
Sure, brother.
Uh-huh. You got that right.
I'm so glad you felt like sitting outside today, Rocco. It's such a beautiful day, and, well, I started thinking about us.
Just move right here.
These past few days have been wonderful. I feel so close to you, even closer than I felt to Jonah the day he slapped me with that restraining order.
There she is. There's my ex.
She's pretty, guy.
Cal, get out of my head.
Rocco, it's not like you to be so aggressive.
I can't help myself anymore because you're so, hot. Our first kiss. Now, here. I'm ready, Charity.
Who is the man that'll seduce all the women with his seduction plan? Who is the cat that'll be having Miss Kimmy all up on his jimmy?
Oh. I won't let you do it, best pal guy. I won't let you throw away your life for sex.
Move upside and let the man go through.
Okay. Watch out for DVDs, guy.
Hey, Nitz, you made it. Things are crazy around here, so why don't we go somewhere with a little more privacy?
You've read my mind, baby. You have read my mind.
There's a 24-hour flu going around, and we've been swamped. What are you doing?
It's on repeat. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I wanna kiss you all over.
Nitz, are you feeling okay?
I don't feel half as good as you look.
Excuse me?
You heard me, woman. Don't try and fight this thing between us. You don't have to anymore. Kiss me, Kimmy Burton. Kiss me like I know you can.
Oh, Rocco.
Mm-hmm.
I can't!
This is wrong! Huh? What are you talking about?
You're so good and pure! It's wrong of me to force myself on you like this!
No, it isn't! Go ahead! Force!
Here you are, a sweet, innocent virgin, and I'm practically accosting you!
No, you're not! I'm not even a virgin!
What?
I just said that to get into your pants!
How could you! You pig!
Rocco, huh? Just as I expected. Oh. My. God.
I thought.
Nitz, that was totally perfect. You're, like, amazing.
I am?
I had no idea you were so good. I can't wait to tell the RA group we've got our new date rape actor. Thank you so much.
Hmm.
Imagine that.
two people actually having sex in the health center. How silly.
Your test results are in, Mr. Evans. You're clean. 100% disease-free.
Whew. Thanks, nurse lady. Thanks a whole bunch.
All in all, I'm pretty happy with the way things turned out.
What are you talking about? You didn't get late. You didn't even get close. You sucked almost as badly as I sucked.
Yeah, but it's a step in the right direction. And a kiss on the cheek from Kimmy Burton is worth a thousand nights in the sack with any other girl.
Even...
Yes, Cal. Even Rosie O'Donnell.
After days of researching, cross-referencing, being in the most hardcore of hardcore chat rooms, seeing things no man should ever see, I have proven that Mulder and Scully never slept together. Not before, not during, not after any of the X-Files episodes or movies.
Well, what about in that episode where Fox hooks up with Scully on that ocean liner in that alternate dimension?
Alternate dimensions don't count!
Get your buzz three ways. Buzzworthy.com brings you new music on MTV, MTV2, and MTV.com. Catch all new episodes of Undergrad Sunday nights at 8, only on MTV.